Welcome to the penultimate stage on this year's Tour of Italy, and the last day in the mountains. In fact, most of the day spent out of the mountains, but it ends with a bang. The 196-kilometre route begins in Saint-Vincent and follows the Dora Baltea out of the Aosta Valley. It continues south from Ivrea towards Turin, where it picks up the Dora Riparia and turns westwards until Susa. There, all riders will take a gulp of air as they turn south for the assault on the Colle delle Finestre at 2,178 metres, the highest point of the tour. 18.45 kilometres at an average of 9.2%, of which 7.8 kilometres are unpaved. Then it's back downhill to Pourrières to begin the final climb of the tour, up into the Sestriere ski resort. A gentle 9.2 kilometre climb to 2,035 metres at 5.4%. Acceleration by Bardet.
There's a breakaway in the leading group. Several riders are attempting to break away. There's now more than a minute between the breakaway and the pack. The breakaway is not to everybody's liking. The peloton has significantly increased its speed. That's more than 2 minutes separating them. The pack really doesn't look interested in following the breakaway. Things have slowed right down. Fall in the pack. Apparently, the leader is on the ground. There's a mass crash in the pack, but it doesn't look too serious. Uh-oh, the pack seems to have woken up and now they're gaining ground!
Bardet goes onto the attack.
The pack is increasing its work rate. Some teams can't be happy with the breakaway. Fall in the pack! Apparently, the leader is on the ground! A fall has just happened in the peloton. Several riders are on the ground.
Bardet goes onto the attack.
The pack's deficit is being cut back. A couple of teams have set themselves up as pacemakers for the pack. They obviously don't have anybody in the breakaway group.
Acceleration by Bardet.
They're moving along at a fair lick. You've just got to hang on. A symbolic kilometer as we go through the halfway stage of the race.
Attack by Bardet.
A rider just launched an attack. They really are moving. The pack can't get strung out too far, or it's going to start breaking up. There we go. That's two-thirds of the race behind us. There's a sustained rhythm at the moment. Some riders definitely won't be able to keep up. This climb is feared by many riders. The percentages are very high. Our rider has a flat tire. Let's hope he has helped out quickly. Riders are falling off the back. It's not a good moment to be going through a bad patch. It's in such percentages that the strongest can create some gaps. The pace is so high that a few riders are going to be very sore at the end of the day.
Counterattack by Romain Bardet.
The riders are going through a very tough portion with percentages above 10%. The front group is disorganized, and some riders are exploiting this opportunity to attack. The Entente in the escape group is far from cordial. There are a couple of riders who want to go it alone. So now it's the descent. It's less physically exhausting than a climb, but it's more stressful as the riders must choose their trajectory well and maintain a good position on the bike. Finish line is getting close. The riders have just passed the 15 kilometers road sign. A leader is down! The team plans could well be turned upside down! Ten kilometers to the finish line. Uh-oh, a leader has fallen. We can only hope that it doesn't have any impact on the outcome of the race. There's a collective fall with several riders on the ground. We can only hope that they all get back up. Again, an attack is launched. The group has to break apart. And off he goes! He's giving it one last go! Holy cow, that was a fall! 5 kilometers to the finish line. And they're off! It's going to be very fast!
Victory for Nairo Quintana.
And here are the key moments of the race.